In this video, we're gonna go over 13 things that you should definitely know about a four-stroke dirt bike. All right, we're here to educate. We've got a four-stroke motorcycle in front of us, and we're just gonna tell you some stuff that you may not know, or you may know. If you do know, just stick around. It's gonna be a lot of fun. And if you wanna know about two strokes, we have a two stroke video that we just dropped. It's from our other presenter. His name is Cody Haverfield. He's really goofy, he's fun to watch. Make sure you check that one out. So the first thing that we're gonna get into is we're just gonna explain like the differences in how the engine works. You hear four strokes, you hear two strokes. So four stroke, what the idea here is that when the piston's going around and the crank's turning, it takes the crank four crank revolutions per exhaust and combustion cycle. So it's moving up and down four times to make all that magic happen. Look, I'm not a mechanic. I just know that that's a little bit of the science behind it. If you want to know more, there's actually videos out there where you can find information. The second thing we're going to go over is the piston is larger compared to the same classification on a two-stroke. For instance, this is a 450. You would race a 250cc bike in this class. It's a little less power, a little harder to manage. The piston is actually just 250cc, so a little smaller. This is 450cc, so a little bigger. The third thing is they're just heavier in general than a two-stroke bike. So if you're looking for something more nimble, more light, more flickable, maybe a two-stroke is your bike. The four-stroke is gonna be a little heavier, more planted, feel like you're sticking to the ground a little more. Number four, it's more electronic capabilities. Now this has highs and lows. You got more electronics, there's more problems that can arise, but you also have more advantages, i.e. traction control, starting programs, stuff that helps you up the start, things like that. So on this one, there has like a start button and like a couple other buttons. On a two-stroke, you have no buttons. You have a kill switch and you kick the bike, you start it. And so there's a difference in that. Number five, a more planted feel. And we did talk about this a little bit, but I wanna kind of give you a little better idea. When the power is more linear, which you have here, and you have more weight, the bike is just gonna naturally feel a little more stuck to the ground. The bikes are typically a little more modern build. The frames are a little more modern, so the suspension's a little more advanced. A lot of the times, the two strokes, aside from a couple manufacturers, are old technology, right? So these bikes just seem to handle a little better with the way that the motor works, how much they weigh, and the geometry and all the different things that they've added in the new year bikes. Number six, something that's really cool is that all manufacturers are producing four strokes. That's what they lead in. They're trying to sell four strokes. They're trying to get people on four strokes. They're trying to move away from two strokes because a lot of that has to do with like your environmental reasons, two stroke fumes and things like that. These are a little more environmental friendly. So I think that they think the life of these bikes are a little longer. So they're really pushing the four stroke. So all manufacturers are producing these bikes. Quickly guys, in between all this stuff, how you could support the channel is if it's just as simple as a like and subscribe, we'd be super grateful for that. If you wanna take it to the next level, make sure you sign up to our email list. You get cool free videos, you know when our camps are coming. And we also have a Patreon account where you can make super small monthly donations, as you've heard before, to help keep this channel moving forward. Thank you guys. Number seven is an interesting one. Four strokes are what the pros race on. You very rarely are gonna see a race that's a very big pro race that everyone's riding two-stroke. They do one-off races that are two-stroke races for fun, kind of nostalgia from back in the day, but all races, all serious series are on four-stroke motorcycles these days. Pro racers race four strokes. Number eight, they're a little more difficult to work on. The reason behind that is there's just more going on in the engine and there's less room in the engine bay. The fact that the motor's bigger means there's less room inside the frame. It's harder to get your hands in there. You gotta take apart more things to get to the parts that you need to work on. So just more difficult to work on. Number nine, probably the most difficult one is they're just in general more expensive to work on, more expensive to buy up front. They lose their value, it seems like, more. They're more expensive bikes. In comparison, like let's say a 250 two-stroke is about $7,000. This 450 is right at $10,000. You can ride both of those bikes in the same class. The 450 is a little bit of an advantage, but if you're a really good rider, you should be able to compete at a local level on a 250 with the 450s. Number 10, this is my opinion only, they're less fun. They're less fun. That's all, that's my opinion. I feel like riding a two-stroke is more fun. The reason that I feel that way is you're more active on it. You're moving around the bike more, you're trying to find traction, you're modulating the clutch and the power differently. You're really just trying to get the bike to do what you want it to do, where these kind of do it on their own. They're like, they're really good, they're really planted, they're really easy to manage power and stuff like that. So for me, especially on soft dirt, two-strokes are so fun. Number 11, they're easier to learn on. Okay, so we teach all of our riders here on air-cooled four-stroke bikes, which are just less power. They have more of a linear power and definitely a lot less hit. And so what you find on a two-stroke versus a four-stroke is that you have a power band on a two-stroke, so it goes from no power to all the power pretty quickly. These have a little more torque, so they have a little more on the bottom, but they kind of just ramp up evenly. So if you're new, they're not giving you as many surprises per se of what a two-stroke could possibly do. So just in general, easier to learn to ride on. Number 12, it's easier to relax when you're riding as a racer. If it's something to do with your fitness, a two-stroke's gonna exaggerate that. So if you're not fit on the motorcycle, two-stroke's gonna wear you out faster. If it's something to do with like, hey, I'm a little wild on the bike, I need to learn how to smooth out, a four-stroke's gonna help with that. A two-stroke is likely not gonna help with that unless you're extremely focused on your technique. So just in general, the bikes are easier to ride, which puts you in a more relaxed state. 13, our final something. You don't have to mix the gas in these. You just pour and pump gas, right? So it's like actually kind of nice. You don't have to figure out where your ratio ride is, where your two-stroke oil is, if you've mixed it or if you haven't mixed it, blowing up your bike if you forget, right? Just dump the gas and go fast. All right, guys, that's a few of what four-strokes have to offer. If you like that, make sure you leave down in the comments your opinion. Also, let us know what you think about Cody presenting on the two-stroke video. We'd like to get him out more, so we want to know your opinion. Don't forget to like, subscribe, follow the app at the MX Factory Instagram, and check out the Patreon account. We're forever grateful. We'll see you guys. Peace.